Moving on to the next one. So this is a, I believe, a very large population of the investor audience who has typically been a multi-cap or a large cap investor.
Yeah.
They've been allocating money and they started looking at mid and small cap funds in just the last 12 to 15 months, right? Given that there was enough evidence to say that mid caps have, you know, corrected a lot.
Yeah.
So if I recall correctly, 2015 to right up to
2017, yeah.
Saw a massive peak in the mid cap segment, and obviously valuation then came off after Feb 18. We've seen that valuations came off, and it was natural for people to explore this segment of the market as well. However, I think now they are actually really they burned their fingers there as well, and then the feeling is, should we move back to large caps? So is large cap the safe haven?
No, I personally, if you ask me, I am a big advocate or a big votary, or I'm always in favor of mid caps actually. And this is not today, this has been right through my entire experience. I've always been in favor of mid caps. The reason being that, and let's leave the regulatory definitions aside, but from my perspective, even before the regulatory definition came in, I used to always think that anything which is, say, 4,000 to 5,000 crore right up to 30,000 crore. So you look at it, say, $500 million to about $4 billion. Is what mid cap is, let's say you put it that way. So as per my understanding, before the regulation changed, I used to always think that stock number 101 to 400 would be mid cap, say, for more or less, that's where the market would be. Now, why I'm talking that I'm always a votary of mid caps is because the best of brands, say, I'll give you a lot of examples. All the mid cap banks, some of the insurance companies, domestic pharma companies, a lot of consumer companies, a lot of brands within consumer, white goods, a lot of these guys, building materials, a lot of these guys are actually mid-cap companies in our country. Some of the best brands, the Batas and the Voltas and the VIPs of the world, they all are mid-cap companies. So I am actually strictly against somebody making this comment that, only large cap, pure large cap. Maybe if you want strong, stable companies, but in today's market, there's nothing like large cap and mid cap. Pretty much everything has fallen as much.
No, so I think this is coming from the thought process that 2018 and 2019, a large part of 19 was very polarized.
There is a correlation. Frankly, if you ask me, all these asset class movements are correlated. Okay, and they move pretty much in tandem. 2018-19 was a outlier year, and what happened in 2019 happened only once before, that was 2002, because in both these times we had very, very narrow and very low economic growth, so the performance got concentrated in few companies. So that's what was called polarization. So my sense is that these are only time, very rare that large cap goes up and the other things go down. Typically they are actually correlated. I am not a big fan for small caps. Okay, so 1000 crore company, 2000 crore company, 500 crore company, that doesn't appeal to me. But I'm always a fan of investing in mid-cap, and like I said, not the regulatory definition. When I say mid-cap, I meant more like 4,000 to 5,000 crore right up to 30,000 crore. So last point on your
shift from large cap or stay invested in whatever fund?
No, they should be remaining invested. See, because for a moment, if you go by the very, very recent data, the very recent data says that mid and small cap has been more negative and more on a downtrend and more volatile. There's a simple rule. If you lose money in an asset class with, say, volatility X, to recover that, you need to be in an asset class of volatility X or more than X.
Absolutely. Right? This is like a very classic.
It's a simple rule, very simple rule. If you lose money in an asset whose volatility is X, and then you move to another asset whose volatility is half or something, I don't think I'm not sure if you have the potential to
actually recover.
So once you have taken the downside of a particular asset, there's no point in taking the downside and then saying that, okay, now this doesn't work for me. If you've taken the downside, then now you have to wait for the upside, and you just have to make sure that you're not in all kind of junk kind of companies where the businesses are broken and they are basically headed to zero. But that doesn't happen when you're in a diversified mutual fund, like we already clarified.
Okay, now coming to SIP, right? Now the SIP revolution, so to say, began in the last couple of years, and we've seen inflows going up and up. In fact,
The way the market is going, you're going to see a gulp revolution, actually.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.